Abba, Father. Ezekiel chapter 14. And the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Son of man, these men have set up their idols in their heart and put the stumbling block of their iniquity before their face. Should I be inquired of all by them? Therefore, speak unto them and say unto them, Thus saith the Lord God, Every man of the house of Israel and the house of planet Earth and the house of America that setteth up his idols in his heart and putteth the stumbling block of his iniquity before his face and comes to the prophet I the Lord will answer him that cometh according to the multitude of his idols that I may take the house of Israel and the house of Manoah in their own hearts because they are all estranged from me through their idols. Therefore, say unto the planet Earth, unto the house of Israel, and the house of America, Thus saith the Lord God, Repent, and turn yourselves from your idols, and turn away your faces from all your abominations. For every one of the house of Israel and the house of the planet Earth are of the stranger that sojourns in Israel, which separateth himself from me and set up his idols in his heart and put up the stumbling block of his iniquity before his face and cometh to a prophet to inquire of him concerning me. I, the Lord God Almighty, will answer him by myself. And I will set my face against that man, and will make him a sign and a proverb. And I will cut him off from the midst of my people, and you shall know that I am the Lord. Verse 9. And if the prophet be deceived when he has spoken a thing, I, the Lord, have deceived that prophet, and I will stretch out my hand upon him, and will destroy him from the midst of my people. And they shall bear the punishment of their iniquity. The punishment of the prophet shall be even as the punishment of him that seeketh unto him. If the house of Israel and the house of the planet Earth may go no more astray from me, neither be polluted any more with all their transgressions, but that they may be my people, and I may be their God, saith the Lord God Almighty. Verse 12. The word of the Lord came again to me, saying, Son of man, when the lands sinneth against me by trespassing grievously, then will I stretch out mine hand upon it, and will break the staff of the bread thereof, and will send famine upon it, and will cut off man and beast from it. Verse 14. Though these three men, Noah, Daniel, and Job, were in it, they should deliver but their own souls by their righteousness, saith the Lord God. And if I cause noisome beasts to pass through the land, and they spoil it, so that it be desolate, that no man may pass through because of the beast. Though these three men were in it, as I live, saith the Lord God, they shall deliver neither sons nor daughters. They only shall be delivered, but the land shall be desolate. Or if I bring a sword or destroying weapon upon that land, and say, sword, destroying weapon, go through the land, so that I cut off man and beast from it. Though these three men were in it, as I live, saith the Lord God, they shall deliver neither sons nor daughters, but they only shall be delivered themselves. Or if I send a pestilence into that land, and pour out my fury upon it in blood, to cut it off from it, man and beast, though Noah, Daniel, and Job were in it, as I live, saith the Lord God, they shall deliver neither son nor daughter. They shall but deliver their own souls by their own righteousness. For thus saith the Lord God, how much more when I send my four sword judgments upon the earth and upon Jerusalem, the sword, and the famine, and the noisome beast, and the pestilence, to cut off from it man and beast. Yet behold, therein shall be left a remnant that shall be brought forth, both sons and daughters. Behold, they shall come forth unto you, and you shall see their way and their doings. And you shall be comforted concerning the evil that I brought upon the earth, and upon America, and upon Jerusalem, even concerning all that I have brought upon it. Verse 23, and they shall comfort you when you see their ways and their doings, and you shall know that I have not done without cause all that I have done in it, saith the Lord God Almighty. Psalms chapter 62. Truly, my soul waits upon God. From Him cometh my salvation. He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be greatly moved. How long will you imagine mischief against a man? You shall be slain, all of you, as a bowling wall shall you be, and as a tottering fence. The only consult to cast him down from his excellency. They delight in lies. They bless with their mouth, but they curse inwardly. My soul wait thou only upon God, for my expectation is from Him. He is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be moved. In God is my salvation and my glory. The rock of my strength and my refuge is in God. Trust in Him at all times, you people. Pour out your heart before Him. God is a refuge for us. Surely men of low degree are vanity, and men of high degree are a lie to be laid in the balance. They are altogether lighter than vanity. Trust not in oppression, and become not vain in robbery. If riches increase, set not your heart upon them. God has spoken once, twice I have heard this, that power belongeth unto God. Also unto thee, O Lord, belongeth mercy, for thou renderest to every man according to his work.